Ladies and gentlemen, it's that time again. From high atop Town Center Place in exciting downtown Ypsilanti, in CTN's beautiful Art Deco Avalon Studio. Yes, Ipsy, where the beer is cold and the women are hot and reasonably priced. Where tonight's show is brought to you by Wikipedia, the Ipsy Bookmobile, and the Michigan Bridge Card. Tonight's guest is Tom Saunders with his new book, The Athletic Benchley. So pull up a chair, relax, open a lovely beverage. Yes, she's here, she's complicated, she's certified. She was raised on promises and believes music is the weapon of the future. So it's time now for Happy Half Hour with YpsiGirl.
A beverage, honey?
Oh yeah, you know, it's code. It's code. You know what a beverage is.
Beverage, yes, I do. Thank you for a wonderful opening, baby. This is our 10th episode, our series, Happy Half Hour with YpsiGirl. Yep. And we're on every second and fourth Friday of the month now, 7 o'clock, right here. And we have some news for all of you out there. Baby, you and I got married the other week.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought you looked especially beautiful.
Oh, thank you, sweetie. Did you notice something different about me?
Could it be your finger, maybe, or...
Well, that, but no, I changed something.
What did you change?
You really don't recognize anything different.
Your hair?
Thank you. Yeah, I got it cut.
I know. Yeah, those beautiful long pink locks. I saw them on the beautician floor there.
So anyway,
I think they used pinking shears, right?
Pinking shears. Yes, baby. He's even funnier now that we're married, everybody. It's amazing. So let's talk about what we have going on tonight. We have a good friend of ours.
Yes, we do.
He's going to be our special guest.
Yes, Mr. Tom Saunders has a new book out about Benchley, Robert Benchley. I'm wondering how many people know him, but I think they're going to know a lot more about him before this show is over.
Yeah, I have no clue. I mean, I'm coming in here just as a friend tonight. It's not really going to be like an interview because I don't know anything. This is totally out of my era. It's definitely more yours.
He died when I was probably a few years old, too. I even know who George Washington is.
Oh, okay, whatever. You've said that before. But it is, it's from, here's the book right here. See, this is a real book, everybody.
Hardcover.
Yeah. The Robert Benchley.
Just like the big kids do.
The Athletic Benchley. That's the name of it. 105 exercises from the Detroit Athletic Club News. I didn't even know what the Detroit Athletic Club was until Tom told us about the book. So let's find out for all of you out there as well right now. Let's introduce him. This is the one and the only A3 Radio's Folk It host and producer, Tom Saunders, and editor, too,
Yay.
The Athletic Benchley. Hi, Tom.
Hi, lady. Hi, Mrs. Mrs. I get to call you Mrs.
Well, yeah, we had a heck of a wedding, you know. But
that was a wedding.
There was no reason to call the militia out for that thing.
That was a wedding.
Tell me about it.
It was a wedding that cried out for police intervention.
You know.
And so, sure enough, they showed up, and they were there drinking all night.
Yeah,
they were good guys.
I know they cost us a fortune.
I know it was a fun time.
It was a great.
So, how does it feel to be married? How does it feel to be, you know, like married?
I love being married.
Cool.
Of course, this is my third one, and of course, Jesse did sing at both my other ones, but this one is different because we are really like a great team, and I'm actually in love with this guy. And
that works. That helps. You
and
know.
He's
my first time.
Head over heels in love with me.
See, well, why not? I mean,
who
how
isn't?
How many pink-haired women do you know?
That's what it took.
Yeah.
No, that's not true. Jesse, you would you'd fall in love with me even if I were bald, right?
Oh, absolutely. Everybody's told me how you're supposed to answer once you're married.
Now you're talking.
You're right.
You're always right, dear.
You're right.
You're right all the time.
You're right, yes.
Learn that.
And now he's going to be wrong two times because we also have Gemma. He's a stepdad, too.
He's a stepdad all at once.
I could be wrong twice as often.
Wow.
Yep. Wrong twice as often.
What? The hits just keep on coming, don't they? I'm telling you.
And the hits, what about this hit tonight?
This head.
Robert Benchley.
Well, you know Robert Benchley because you've seen him on television for years and years. Because he was the second banana. He was the best friend in all these movies that MGM did in the 30s. He was in Pete's Dragon with for Walt Disney. He was in Road to Utopia with Crosby and Hope. He was in a lot of different movies, but he was never the star. He was always the second guy.
Right, and you don't hear too much about him.
You don't hear a lot about him, although he's an amazing guy. He was one of the founding members of the Algonquin Roundtable, which was the epitome and the establishment of sophisticated humor in the United States.
Really? Were there nights at that table?
Nights and days, mostly lunches. It was Robert Benchley and Dorothy Parker and Mark Conley and Groucho Marx and Edna St. Vincent Millay and Edna Ferber. All of these writers and actors and poets were gathered in New York at that time, and they all became...
They all had lunch, right?
They all had lunch.
And the whole country was on there listening to every... they all covered themselves in their articles.
That's exactly right.
When did you first turn on to Benchley? In the movies?